Today, let us discuss in fluid mechanics the capillary ascent. The meaning of capillary means it is hair thin, a tube which is having very small radius, and when compared to its length, then we call it as a capillary tube. So in normal experience tells us that whenever we dip the capillary in any liquid, the liquid rises. So in some cases, of course, liquid rises. In some other cases, it will be the capillary descent will be there. So wherever it is rising, we call it as ascent. Wherever the liquid height is below the liquid, the height of the liquid in the container, then we call it as capillary descent. So let's first talk about capillary ascent. So in the capillary ascent, suppose if you put a capillary tube in any container of liquid, then the liquid rises just because of surface tension. Now we wanted to see why the rise is taken place. That's first thing. The second one is what are the different forces acting at that particular point of time. Now let me draw this capillary very big just to make you to see. So here this is the capillary. So the water is up to this and here in the gaps. So we have to calculate the water up to this height and then this, the water that is entering into these gaps. So first of all, let us talk about the forces. The surface tension is always acting in tangentially, and the reaction of that surface tension will be acting in the opposite direction. So let's call it as T. And if this angle, the angle between the wall and this surface tension is known as angle of contact. Here the angle of contact is theta, and this theta is acute. So theta here is less than 90. So wherever angle of contact is less than 90, then a concave surface takes place. If theta is equal to 90, then a flat surface. If theta is greater than 90, then convex surface. See, here the angle of contact, if it is less than 90, the meniscus is in the shape of concave. We can give the example here, water and glass. Suppose if you pour the water in a glass container, glass tumbler, then you will see that it is in the concave meniscus. So water in glass. Okay. Now this, you can give the example, water in copper container. Copper container. Now here you can give the glass and the mercury. Suppose if your mercury is poured in glass container, then mercury will have the convex shape. Here the cohesive forces are greater than the adhesive forces. Here cohesive forces are less than adhesive forces, and here cohesive forces are equal to adhesive forces. What are cohesive forces? You already know that the force of attraction between the molecules of the same liquid is called cohesive force. The force of attraction between two different substances. In this case, the water molecules and glass molecules, they have some attraction with each other, and that is called adhesive. So if cohesive is more than adhesive, then the angle will be more than 90, obtuse angle, convex shape, and it does not wet the glass. Now if theta is equal to 90, neither convex nor concave, it remains flat. And if theta is less than 90, that is where cohesive forces are less than adhesive forces, then it gives the concave shape. So now we have to talk about the liquid. We are considering that the liquid makes an angle. The contact angle of contact is less than 90. So now what are the forces there? So we have discussed that T is in this direction, and if theta is that, then we can, this is theta, this is T cos theta, this is T sin theta. Now similarly, at this position, suppose if it is A, let's consider the position at B. At B also, we have T in this direction, T sin theta and T cos theta. So now from this free body diagram, we can see that all the sin theta components are getting cancelled. So let me tell you, suppose if it is the total a liquid container is like this, then one sin theta component is like this, the other sin theta component is exactly opposite to it, and that is cancelling with it, with each other. So like that, some component may be here and an equal and opposite component may be here. So like that, around the container, all the T sin theta components will be cancelling with each other. So now what is left out? T cos theta components. So T cos theta components are all along the circumference. We know that surface tension is force per unit length. Surface tension is force per tension is force per unit length. Therefore, to calculate the force, we write force is equal to surface tension into length. Now T cos theta into length, that is 2 pi r. Therefore, this is the force acting in the upward direction. Now what is in the downward direction? So there should be some downward direction, otherwise it would have continuously risen up. So the downward force is nothing but the weight of the liquid. Now we have to calculate the weight of the liquid. To calculate the weight of the liquid, first of all, we have to calculate the volume times density times g, because mass is nothing but volume into density. So volume, while calculating volume, if you consider that this is the height risen above this is the height h, then what happens? The cylindrical volume is pi r square h, but there is some water in this gap. So if, what is that gap? Just let me mark with this black. So this water you have to calculate. For calculating that, you can assume that a cylinder of the radius r, that is how much, what should be the volume of it? It is pi r square, and this height is also equal to r, minus this volume of the hemisphere. So volume of the hemisphere is how much? 2 by 3 pi r cube. Therefore the resultant is 1 by 3 pi r cube. So this is extra volume of this water, so we have to add that to this, that is 1 by 3 pi r cube times rho times g. That is, if you take pi r square as common, r h plus r by 3 times rho g. Our aim is to calculate the capillary ascent, this h. So let us equate, this is downward force, this is upward force. Therefore, 2t cos theta into 2 pi r, 2t cos theta into pi r, because I have taken this 2 here, that is equal to pi r square into h plus r by 3 times rho g. So I can cancel one pi, another r, so that one r is left out. So this h plus r by 3 is equal to 2t cos theta by r rho g. Now h is equal to 2t cos theta by r rho g minus r by 3. Already we discussed that capillary ascent or capillary tube will have very small radius when compared to its length. Therefore, we can neglect this one and we can finally write 2t cos theta by r rho g. So this is the capillary ascent. So here, if smaller is the radius of the capillary, height of the ascent, that is capillary ascent, will be larger. So when if you take different capillary tubes of different radii, then we know that 2t cos theta, it remains same for all, because we are considering the same liquid in the same container and density is same, g is same. Therefore, r times h is always constant. So r1 h1 is equal to r2 h2 is equal to r3 s3 and so on. So this is the formula for capillary ascent. In examination, if they are not talking anything about theta, if theta is given some 4 degrees, 5 degrees, it's okay. We have to substitute there. If nothing is given, you can consider that theta is equal to 0. And we can straight away write the formula 2t by r rho g. So here h is capillary ascent, r is the radius of the capillary tube, rho is the density, g is acceleration due to gravity, t is surface tension, theta is angle of contact. So in the case of mercury, so you will have to get, we will get the 2t cos theta by r rho g, but it is capillary descent. So if you draw the figure for mercury, so this is outside liquid. Here the inside, the liquid will be rising up to, so it is less than the container, this one. So this is also equal to 2t cos theta by r rho g, but it is less than the height of the container. So this height, so this is called capillary descent and this is called capillary ascent.